black too? Really? No one should have to choose one identity over the other. We all have multiple identities that make us unique and worthy. I stand on the shoulders of giants. Barbara Jordan, democracy is not a spectator sport. Fannie Lou Hamer, tired of being sick and tired. Rosa Parks sat down so her people could stand up. Byron Rustin persevered despite folks' ignorance and intolerance of his strength and fortitude. The National Black Justice Coalition is a civil rights organization dedicated to empowering black, lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender people. NBJC's mission is to end racism and homophobia. As America's leading national black LGBT civil rights organization focused on federal public policy, the National Black Justice Coalition has accepted the charge to lead black families in strengthening the bonds and bridging the gaps between the greater African American communities and black LGBT people and communities. NBJC provides leadership at the intersection of mainstream civil rights and mainstream LGBT organizations, advocating for the unique challenges and needs of the African American LGBT community that are often relegated to the sidelines. NBJC envisions a world where all people are fully empowered to participate safely, openly, and honestly in family, faith, and community, regardless of race, gender identity, or sexual orientation. This is not black versus gay, because NBJC represents black lesbians, gays, bisexuals, and transgender people. Gay rights as civil rights, should not civil rights be protective of gay rights? Poet Nikki Giovanni taught me that civil rights is the big blanket, and it should keep everybody who needs protection warm, whether it is the disabled, or gays, or the elderly, or immigrants, everybody is worthy of protection of civil rights. It is something to really look deep internal as a people. And even though we're a mixed company, I'm talking to the black folks in the room. Black on black crime is not cool. And I'm very, very serious when I consider the oppression of my people as a crime, to the point that the federal government has passed new hate crimes, especially with additional protection or recognition of sexual orientation and gender identity. And that includes bullying. Bullying does fall under the umbrella of a hate crime. So the civil rights movement has been a beacon of light for so many movements, just as Gandhi and India's nonviolence and successful fight for freedom from British control was to Dr. King, Byron Rustin, and other leaders of the civil rights movement. As black folk, we have seen women's rights, immigrant rights, Native Americans, the disabled, and other oppressed people appropriating the struggle of our ancestors. Why is it okay for every other movement in the world to look to the civil rights movement for its successes, except for the LGBT equality movement? Why? This is about the fact that all God's children are special and beautiful. No room to pick and choose which struggle is or was greater than the other. It is simply a struggle. So as I close, I really want everyone here to open your hearts and your minds and be prepared to just be honest. Let's have a conversation. Let's get real about it. It's not like you haven't thought it. It's not like you dared to say it in private. But this is an opportunity for an organization like this Hispanic Black Gay Coalition to want to unite its community and want to unite all of its communities to come to the table for a real discussion about how the Black LGBT experience, movement, individual, community is respected, viewed, and a significant, recognized part of the African American community and the African American agenda. So personally, I want to thank my husband, Master Sergeant Alvin Hicks, who's over there on the wall. Retired from the United States Air Force, who's here with me today, because we have committed our family, our entire family, both ends of our family, to the struggle of loving all mankind. We are deeply rooted, and it keeps me fueled every day in the pursuit of full equality. Thank you. this very conversation about our black LGBT people, black too. And I'm happy to put up the March edition that came on the newsstands last week, that starting on page 140. So Darnell, you know we're serious about bridging this gap around this country. There is a 4-page exclusive special report on Five million readers, 4 pages about black lesbians, active duty,